Hollywood, Colgate Tooth Powder, for a breath that's sweet and teeth that sparkle, presents The Mel Blanc Show. Colgate Tooth Powder, for a breath that's sweet and teeth that sparkle, brings you The Mel Blanc Show with Mary Jane Croft, Earl Ross, Bea Benadera, Joe Kern, Sookie, and Victor Miller and his orchestra. Ladies and gentlemen, you've heard Mel Blanc as the happy postman.
Hello, Mr. Burns. Here's your mail. Well, goodbye, Mrs. Burns. Remember, keep smiling.
You've heard him as the famous train caller.
Train leaving on track 5 for Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga.
You've heard him as Pedro.
Pardon me for talking in your face, Senorita. 30 days hacienda, April 20th, sombrero.
You've heard him as the lovable character, Sookie.
Well, he in the fix a job on the president. I'm the vice president, I'm the trash head. I sweep out the place.
You heard him as the famous Warner Brothers cartoon character, Bugs Bunny.
What's up, Doc?
Now hear him as the star in his own show.
Hello, Mel Blanc's fix a job. You bend it, we bend it.
Have a broken chair in your house, broken table in your house, anything that's housebroken? Well, don't try to fix it yourself. Don't ruin it. Bring it to Mel Blanc. Let him do it. Right now in the fix-it shop, Mel's uncle is talking to our hero, General Assistant Sookie.
Sookie, come here, will you?
Exactly.
I haven't been everything to you. No.
bag and pick up some birthday cards.
Joyous of all occasions, your very own
name thing. Your name thing, that means birthday. trying to get 98 birthday presents for all the people I sent cards to. Oh, if I don't, they'll never come near the fixing job.
Ha ha ha!
back at the fix-it shop in just a minute for a Zookieism. What's a Zookieism? Wait and see.
Use cold cake to powder. Keep silent just right. Use it each morning. And use it each night.
Don't take a chance with your romance.
Use cold cake to powder.
Take it from me, that little breath of trouble, I mean unpleasing breath, will they end in friendship or even give the air to a love affair? And the worst of it is, you may not even suspect it, because unpleasing breath can catch up with you without your knowing it. So ask yourself, could you be the victim of unpleasing breath? Guard against it this way. Brush your teeth night and morning and before every date with Colgate tooth powder. For Colgate tooth powder cleans your breath as it cleans your teeth. Yes, scientific tests have definitely proved that in 7 cases out of 10, Colgate tooth powder instantly stops unpleasing breath that originates in the mouth. What's more, no dentifrice at any price cleans your teeth more quickly and thoroughly than Colgate tooth powder. Remember to buy it first thing, and remember the name Colgate tooth powder with the accent on powder.
Don't take a chance with you.
Collect the garbage.
Oh, Katie, to
Today is my wedding anniversary. George has been my favorite husband for 10 years.
Oh, Mrs. Cooper, it hasn't been 10 years.
Well, not exactly. It's really been 9 years, 11 months, 29 days, 22 hours, and 45 minutes.
I knew it wasn't 10 years.
Just think, Katie, 10 years ago, I was an eager young bride of 21. And today, I'm an old married woman of 25. What George will give me. What is the 10th anniversary, Katie? The 50th is gold and the 25th is silver. Is the 10th diamond or china?
It's tin.
Tin? T-I-N?
That's right, like in C-A-N.
Oh. Well, George probably doesn't know anything about it being tin, so let's not tell him. What he doesn't know won't hurt me.
You'll be lucky if Mr. Cooper remembers that your anniversary.
Why, Katie, of course he'll remember.
I don't know. Husbands have strange memories. They can't remember the day they were married, but they can tell you Ty Cobb's batting average in 1922.
Well, George is different.
Hey, Liz, where are you?
You watch. The first thing he'll say when I walk into the breakfast room is, "Happy anniversary, darling."
I'll be listening at the door.
Good morning, my wonderful little husband.
Oh, morning, dear. what is it, dear?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, Liz.
Yes, dear?
This coffee is cold.
Well, I'll get some hot for you. George, are you just going to sit there reading the paper? Haven't you something to tell me?
No. Oh, certainly.
I thought so.
Dick Tracy found the jewel.
Oh, get your own coffee.
So what's the matter with you?
Haven't you any idea what this day is?
Sure. Oh, my gosh, this is the day I have to send in my car payment.
George, what was Ty Cobb's batting average in 1922?
385. That didn't make you follow baseball.
Oh, and I thought you loved me.
Oh, well, I do, honey. What's the matter with you? You're sure acting crazy today.
Well, a girl has a right to act crazy on her anniversary.
Horse, drive to one side and park your vehicle.
I mean, of course it is. Oh, I knew it all the time, dear. I was just teasing.
Oh, you were?
Of course.
Well...
Well, how could I forget our 15th anniversary? Ah! Now what's the
no matter? Sudden moves!
Well, it seemed like... I mean, it doesn't seem like so much wonderful fun could be crowded into 10 measly years.
Oh, really?
Of course. And if you don't believe I remembered our anniversary, look here in this little memo book of mine. There, what does that say?
It says, buy anniversary present for Liz.
See?
Oh, George, you did remember.
How could I forget the luckiest day of my life? Say, what are you supposed to give on the 10th anniversary anyway?
Don't you know?
No.
Well, then I do.
What is it, the lead? Pewter?
No. Diamond wristwatches.
Never heard of that.
Well, you wouldn't want to give me just plain old diamonds. They have to be in something. So, it might as well be a wristwatch.
Liz, I don't have the money to buy you a diamond wristwatch.
Well, how about just diamonds?
How about just the wristwatch?
Well, okay.
I'll see if I can find a tin one.
Oh, you knew it all the time.
Honey, I'm afraid we'll have to buy each other inexpensive little gifts. We'll put a limit on them.
All right, George. After all, it's the thought that counts. Shall we say $50?
Shall we say $5?
Well, let's compromise. I'll spend $5 for your present, and you spend $50 for mine.
Sorry, Spendthrift. $5 is the limit. Hey, it's getting late. I've got to get down to the bank.
Isn't it funny, George? You work at the bank with all that money around, and yet you can only spend $5.
Liz.
Goodbye, George.
Goodbye, Liz. Happy anniversary.
Happy Annie. under the $5 limit. Where can I get $5?
I think something's burning in the kitchen. Katie, come here. How much do you need, Mrs. Cooper?
If you'll loan me $4.50, I can make it.
I've only got 2.5.
I'll take it.
But that only makes $3.
Well, it works out. Don't you see? He gives me a $5 present. I give him a $3 tie, and he owes me $2.
Good of you to come along and help me choose Iris's birthday present.
Well, I'm glad you asked me, Mr. Anniversary. I have to buy Liz an anniversary present today.
Oh? How long ago was your anniversary?
Today.
Today? How did you remember?
I didn't. I forgot until Liz reminded me this morning. She thinks I remembered, though.
You must be a fast talker, boy.
No, it's simple. I always carry a special mail book. On one page, it says, get Liz's birthday present. The next page says, get Liz's anniversary present. Another one says, get Liz's Valentine present.
That's pretty clever.
Sure. No matter when she jumps on me, I can prove I made a note to do.
Well, Iris just keeps mum. Every day that I've forgotten, she adds $10 to the cost of the present I have to buy her.
Oh, brother. What are you getting her for her birthday?
A mink coat.
Mink?
Her birthday was last fall.
Oh, it's mink.
It was either the mink skin or mine. Oh, say, here's the fur department. Pardon me, miss, could you wait on us?
Well, they asked me to stay here until the regular girl gets here. She's late. I never worked in furs before. If you'd like to wait for her.
No, no, we're in a hurry.
Well, try. I don't know my way around in furs.
We understand.
I know everything there is to know in nightgowns. That's my department.
I believe you. I'd like to see some mink coats.
Mink?
Yes, mink.
Oh, yes, sir. Here's a lovely one here. A full name.
Right, that's very, very nice. How much is it?
Well, let's see. Oh, here's the tag. It's only $3,000.
That's a lot of money.
Why, gee, that's entirely too much. Let me find you something else.
No, let me see this one, please.
Why, say not. $3,000? Why, I wouldn't let you spend that much.
I want to see that.
Let's get something cheaper. How about a nice Hudson seal?
I don't want Hudson seal.
Well, forget about the seal. For that money, you can get a new Hudson.
My wife would look pretty silly wearing a new Hudson. She doesn't have that step-down design. Now, would you mind putting that coat on so we can see how it looks?
Would I mind? How do I look?
You look great. What do you think, George?
Oh, it's a beautiful coat.
Oh, I've never worn mink before.
Miss, would you stop swirling around, please?
Oh, I feel so natural to be wearing mink.
$15.
Oh,
it's size 12.
Oh, I'll bet I know what kind you want. Black, What do you think George will give me for my anniversary?
I don't know, Mrs. Goober. What can he get for $5?
Yeah, that's right. All I could find for him was a belt.
Well, that's practical.
So if he doesn't spend more than $5 on me, I'll really give him a belt. And I won't say Hickok on it either.
Look, Mrs. Cooper, in front of the house, a delivery truck.
Oh, it's my present. I know it is. See, the driver's getting it from the back of the truck. Ooh, that's an interesting-looking package he's bringing in. It looks like it could be a dress or a robe. I'll get it. Thank you.
What is it?
I don't know. It's wrapped so beautifully, I can't bear to open it. Oh, go ahead. Well, I should wait till George comes home. Yes, I'll wait. Well, I'll just take a teensy piece in one corner. Good.
Hello?
Hello, George, boy.
Eddie, huh?
Oh, no. They didn't send that one, did they?
Why? What do you mean?
Oh, that isn't the one I bought. I wouldn't have you seen in that cheap old thing. Oh, come on, take it off. I'll send it back.
Well, George, you're the luckiest man in the world because I like this one. Think of all the money you'll save.
Yeah.
Let's go someplace. I want to show the code off. I know. Let's go call on the Atterbury.
Oh, no.
Why not?
Well, let's see. It isn't insured. It isn't safe to wear it out.
Oh, well, then I'll call up and invite them over here.
No. Let's just spend a quiet evening at home, dear.
Oh, I don't want to stay home.
Yes, Mr. Atterbury? Where are you?
Turn off the engine in your vehicle!
You haven't given me any time, but besides, you won't take the darn thing off.
I'll make her take it
off. Keys under the ignition now!
Car bomber, I don't care what that is. That turning the heat up might do it. I'll put it up to 110 degrees.
I am not accustomed to repeating myself! Stop!
Now, please, I'll stand under the dining room window. If you don't have that coat out for me in 15 minutes, I'll come in and tell Liz the truth.
I'll have it, Mr. Atterbury. I'll turn the heat up right now.
Liz, where are you?
Where am I, darling?
What are you doing? And why is every light on in the house?
Oh, I was just going around seeing if my new coat went with each room. It clashes with the dining room door.
Well, let me change it for you.
All right. Gray wallpaper would be nice.
Aren't you a little warm, Liz?
No, I'm too comfortable.
Now, I guess it takes a while.
What does?
Why don't you go to bed, Liz?
Oh, I couldn't go to bed. The coat would get all crushed.
You don't have to wear it to bed, you know.
I wonder if I could hang myself on a hanger and sleep in my coat all night.
Liz, are you sure you aren't warm? I'm stifled.
Phew. I guess it is a little warm, George. Look at the windows. They're all steamed up.
Yeah. I don't know how you can stand it.
Oh, I'm so happy in my little pink. I can't feel anything. Oh, that's the bill. Yes, darling.
Excited,
George. We're safe now. They're taking him off to jail.
Oh,
hello, Mr.
Garden last August. No spices or canning processes have spoiled it. It's the real thing.
You'll get a brand new refreshing drill from your first blast course. And a real benefit to health, too. Vitamins that Campbell's are taking care to retain.
Stop
Campbell's tomato juice. Drink a glass of it just for me, girl, just for George and Gracie. And then another glass just for the George. The mob-level comedy, A Night at the Opera, contains the beautiful ballad entitled Alone. Milton Watson sings it for us now.
Come in, child, the shining bright, the glorified
George and Gracie again.
You know, George, if my brother were as rich as Rockefeller, couldn't he be richer than Rockefeller and vice versa?
That's a nice beginning. If your brother were as rich as Rockefeller, he'd even be richer than Rockefeller?
Sure, he'd still be getting his $5 a week money on the side.
Yeah. Well, which brother is that, sir?
My brother Ike.
Ike?
Yeah, well, we call him Ike for short. He's called him Mr.
Well, Hickok, that's the fool, the good-looking one,
Well, when he gets in the car with everybody, he goes 50-50 on expenses.
So your brother goes 50-50
on expenses? Yeah. The motor is supplied for gas and oil, and my brother supplies for the
airport. Well, that's very considerate of your brother.
Well, I think so. And once upon a time, while my brother...
Well,
my brother was just talking to the car, and he was dying.
We need this area cleared immediately. Clear out everyone. If you can hear me, get the fuck out.
Oh, Milton, don't take it. My uncle had the same opportunity in his little lifetime.
Gracie, quiet with your uncle. What is it, Miss Milton?
Well, James Clean from Paramount is here to look me over.
James Clean?
Yeah, he's a talent stuff.
My daddy's a boy scout. He can make a fire with two sticks.
Well, what was that? Make the fire with two sticks,
man. Please, Gracie, don't mess this up. I need to get a contract out of this if I can make an impression.
Well, what?
Here comes Mr. Kling, though.
Oh, Mr. Kling, how do you do?
How do you do?
Mr. Kling, you know Ted Husing.
How do you do?
And George Byrne.
How do you do?
That's Gracie Allen.
Why, of course. Of course.
Well, hello, Mr. Kling. Are you the thing you have to send the
face? Please, please. Tell me, Mr. Kling, what's new? I hear you're giving Milton Watson the once over.
Well, I happen to be in town. It just occurred to me that Mr. Watson might have possibilities.
No,
Mr.
Possibility at all. Well, now, maybe he ate something that didn't agree with
him. Thank you. That's talking business. Mr. Kling, did you hear Milton Watson's song tonight?
Yes, he has a grand voice.
I can't help wondering how Mr. Watson would feel if you were playing opposite Loretta Young.
Well, now, look, it all depends on what they'd be playing, Mr. Kling. Now, if they were playing football, I bet Milton would be there. But he doesn't want to play post office, you know what I mean,
Yeah, he knows what to say. But stay out of it. Mr. Kling wants to find out a thing, can I?
Yes, especially in your message box.
What? Have you ever had any of these so-called hot lover roles?
Hot lover roles? Well, I hadn't for breakfast, and they're delicious.
Gracie, if I had a girl like you, hot lover alone.